What's up, everybody? I just got the best idea from the YouTube comments section. Now, I know what you're thinking. No good ideas have ever come from there. But hear me out. One of my subscribers, Jared, left this comment. This is a gold mine. It's an absolute gold mine. There are so many bad financial advice TikToks and crypto TikToks. I just had to narrow it down to like 10 for this video. So without further ado, let's just jump in. These are hilarious, guys. Stick around.
About to buy $1 million home for half the price. The thing is, you can only do this if you know how to utilize cryptocurrency.
So this is the house that I'm going to buy.
It's a nice house.
And it costs about $1.4 million. So I'll have to pay around $7,000 a month. But for this house, the total that I need to pay is $740,000. It's because of crypto. For the down payment, I'll have to pay about 20%, which is $290,000. With the remaining $450,000, I'm going to put that into the Anchor protocol. Once I deposit the $450,000, it'll yield me 19% per year. That's $88,000 a year. Now divide that by 12 months, and that's going to make me $7,300 a month, just enough to cover the monthly cost of this mansion. After it's paid off, I'll have a $1.4 million home, plus be making $7,300 a month doing nothing. If you want to learn more about crypto, check out my bio.
I don't want to learn more about crypto. So first of all, Anchor Protocol is offering that high of an APY just to entice customers in. It's not fixed. It's not going to stay that high forever. So don't do this, folks. Also, has anybody even thought about real estate taxes, property taxes? No, just no.
Who do you think runs the world? Girls! No, not even close. Since the 1970s, two corporations have gobbled up most of the Earth's companies, Vanguard and BlackRock. And you might be like, Tony, that's ridiculous. I go to stores all the time and I see competing brands everywhere. The market has genuine competition because I can buy this or that or this or that.
This or that, this or that.
Or this or that.
What is going on? And what is going on?
All publicly traded companies have boards where the largest shareholders make the decisions. So when we investigate who are the largest shareholders of all these companies, the same two companies keep coming up. Vanguard and BlackRock. These two mega corporations own all the smaller corporations, so we have a monopoly inside of a monopoly. Vanguard and BlackRock own Coke and they own Pepsi. They own Apple and they own Android, i.e. Microsoft.
Wait. Microsoft owns Android? I don't know what's more cringe, the dancing or the misinformation.
They own American Airlines, they own Delta. They own oil and they own solar. They own eBay and they own Amazon and they own the car companies and the pharmaceutical companies and the tobacco companies, the food companies, the clothing companies, the insurance companies, the banks.
Okay, that seems a little misogynistic, doesn't it now, guys?
The banks. No matter what industry, the top shareholders are the ones making the decisions. Call me a dingleberry, but if you own all the competing companies in the free market, then I don't think the market is all that free.
Okay, I'm gonna have to stop this one here. She's so close. All she had to do was take her research one step further and Google who owns BlackRock and who owns Vanguard. So close.
Would you rather take $100 cash or a Bitcoin?
$100 cash.
They might be right what they say about blondes, actually. Exactly. I'm going to talk to you guys later, man.
Shots fired! I do have a thing for blondes, though.
And Matt Damon, if you see this, you're a fucking sellout. Fuck you and fuck cryptocurrency.
I know what this one's about. Hold on.
Four simple words that have been whispered by the intrepid since the time of the Romans. Fortune favors the brave.
Fortune favors the brave.
and Matt Damon, if you see this, you're a fucking sellout. Fuck you and fuck cryptocurrency.
You know, I don't disagree with her on this one, though. I don't. This one's been around for a while, but I was stunned when I first saw it, so we're going to give it a go.
What's a piece of information that you learned that feels illegal to know?
That if you start an S corporation and you own 100% of your S corporation, that you can buy everything that you own under that S corporation, and then you don't pay taxes on anything that you purchase because it's considered a corporate expense.
This lady clearly has zero experience with business ownership. Babe, if we just form an LLC and start filing as an S-Corp, we can completely avoid all taxes forever.
And you can take one corporate vacation a year, and depending on how much money your corporation makes, that price actually fluctuates up. And you can actually hire your children to work for you for $12,000 a year tax-free. So then you're actually showing an expense, but you're gifting it back to your own family household. And then you pay yourself a salary, which means you pay less self-employment taxes. And then basically at the end of every month, you're left with $0 to pay real taxes on. It feels really shitty to do it, but it's kind of how you avoid paying taxes. So I don't know.
I don't know where to even start with this one. Okay, first of all, for any of this to work, you need to own a legitimate business that's producing, you know, substantial amounts of revenue. Yeah, you can write off travel, but there does need to be a legitimate business purpose for the travel. Like you could tack on some sightseeing to the end of a business trip, but you can't just go on a business trip and write it off from your business taxes. The IRS looks at that kind of thing. You can also hire your children, but they have to actually be working. That's another thing the IRS looks at. You can't just, you know, engage in nepotism and give your kids a false title. That's fraud. That's tax fraud. Okay. Oh, also, like, no matter how you swing things, even if your kids are legitimately working and engaged in the business, you're going to have to pay FICA taxes, which goes towards American entitlement programs like Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid. At the end of the day, this video is just playing on emotions, the anti-capitalist eat the rich mentality. There's a lot of views on this video. So I don't know. I guess that must be popular. A lot of people fell for that, but this one is going to be good. I can just tell from that title.
I just basically mortgaged my house so I could put all of the equity from the house into XRP. And you might be thinking I am absolutely crazy, but let me explain to you why.
Yes, that's exactly what I'm thinking.
I did that because there is so much fear in the market right now. I love fear, all right? I'm greedy when others are fearful, and I'm fearful when others are greedy, okay? When there's blood in the streets, it's time to play some ball.
So yeah, that is a famous Buffett quote, be fearful when others are greedy and vice versa. But Buffett's also a student of Benjamin Graham and fundamental analysis and only buying things that you have deep knowledge of, companies, you know, in industries that you have deep understanding and knowledge in. You know what? I think I found this guy's best friend. They emailed him, folks. They emailed him. It wasn't just a text message. It was an email.
Take for you to get $3 billion within 6 months.
I'd take $100 million that I have, and I'd go to a big institution and say, "Hey, 10x my 100. That'd be a bill." They'll do that 100%. I'd take the bill, go buy $3 billion. $1 billion will buy $3 or $4 billion worth of real estate. We could do $4 billion this year.
I don't understand why you're thinking so small. Let's do it. Curious why you play so small when you have the opportunity. You just came up with the answer in 10 seconds.
Yeah.
Why wait?
That's why I come here? I came here from a therapy session today. Thank you, Dr. Phil.
Oh, that was hard to watch. Okay, so if the institution is going to 10x your 100 million, then why not just ask them to 10x your billion? Boom! Now you have 100 billion. Whoa! It's that easy.
Are you delusional? Do you suffer from a mental illness? Do you think you do?
I'm thinking about getting rid of this plant. I don't want to associate myself in any way. You know what it is? As a general rule, I just don't take financial advice from Scientologists. I just don't. Okay. That's all I have for today, guys. Look, if you enjoyed any of these, drop a like and subscribe to the channel. That would mean a lot to me. And if you stumble across any of these ridiculous TikToks or YouTube videos, you know, drop them below. Let me know, and maybe I'll tear into some more down the road. Anyways, thank you, and I'll see you in the next one.